keep the track out of it. See how the track, you can see the track right here?
Oh, yes, I think.
So if you zoom, the way you can see more, just somewhere in that range right there, the way you get more view of the game.
Yep.
One son plays varsity, which is 8, number 69. And my youngest son, Ethan, which is a freshman, he gets to rest tonight for his second game. We're getting towards that because this is Copley youth football night also.
And we should be live. Mike's a walk.
You're welcome.
We should be live.
Yeah.
Freedoms like none other. At this time, we invite you to stand. Remove your hats and direct your attention to the south end of the stadium for the playing of our national anthem. Please remain standing for the playing of the Copley alma mater.
Thank you.
marching band during halftime. They'll be performing two parts of their show, Your Life's Blueprint. Plus, we'll have a very special performance with our Copley Fairlawn Middle School 8th grade band. We'll see you at halftime, and go Copley!
Take their mind down. You want to be more of a play-by-play guy?
friends from Herbrook Elementary School, forming a tunnel on the field to cheer our Indians on to victory.
We are on, and we are live from Copley Field. In the booth with me, I've got Gary Bradford on the mic.
Hi, everybody.
I've got Grant Hine on the camera, and I've got Gordon Gachet running the huddle video. Tonight's game between Highland Hornets and your Copley Indians. It's a matchup of a 2-1 team versus an 0-3 team. Copley looking to rebound. Highland looking to continue a winning streak following their opening round loss to Hudson. Copley's gotten off to really hot starts every game so far, and then just struggles down the stretch. So just building step by step if you're the Copley crew, building a young team from the ground up. Highland, with a host of returning players and a mature team, so they're definitely to be reckoned with. And I want to apologize right from the start as Copley enters the field, indicating they'll receive the opening kickoff. To our sponsors, we had so many awesome sponsors that last week I missed an entire wall, and I will make that up to them by giving them double time this week. So thank you to all of our sponsors, and we'll be running through all of your names as the broadcast continues. Last week, we had over 230 viewers. We're hoping to exceed that tonight. Beautiful night for football in Copley. Sun is down, a little bit of cloud cover, but definitely not too hot. So a good night for football for all these players. Should not see a ton of dehydration / cramping on the sideline. And number 40 for Highland, as we are being inundated by bees. I don't see who number 40 is. He's not on our roster, but he's the kickoff specialist for Highland. He's going to kick it deep. McKnight and Bearshack deep for Copley, and it's going to get to Bearshack, who had an opening touchdown return last week, and he gets the corner this week, and he gets across the 30 to the 31, 32 yard line. So a good starting field position for Copley. Julian Bearshack with a nice return. As always, if you cannot see or hear us, please shoot me a text and we will adjust accordingly. That goes to certain people, especially such as Dave Hine, who may be tuned in, whose son is working the camera. So here we go, right out of the gate. Gabe Manzel takes the opening snap, rumbles forward for a gain of about 4 yards. Highland's indicating fumble.
But
the refs are saying he was down, Gary.
Yes.
Another quick snap from Copley. Manziel dropped back to pass, but he's going to be sacked. So real quick, we are 34 seconds into the first quarter. Copley's already run two plays plus return to kickoff. And now Copley with a third down and 13.
Like Highland showing blitz off the right side. Passes out. Scooby's got it. Nope. Out of bounds.
Number Brazil's pass was out of bounds. That brings fourth down for Copley.
So Michael Lickey's back to kick.
So Highland with a good stop here on their first possession. Clock is at 11:01, so Copley's possession lasted 59 seconds. That ball bounces out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Pretty good kick by Lickey.
Lickey with the first fair catch for Highland.
So here comes the Highland offense for the first time.
Highland will start on the 39-yard line.
A lot of familiar names and faces. Copley and the Copley Highland rivalry goes back years.
Yes, clear into the youth football leagues, and it's still going on.
And it's Janicus, which is a familiar name. He's the senior QB for Highland. He's set to take the snap, and he hands it off to Casey Miser, who's a sophomore, and he's rumbling down the sideline and picks up a nice gain of about 33 yards. First down Highland on the Casey Miser run.
Looks like they're going to mark it at 28?
And Gary, we know Casey from youth football days.
Yes.
At some point, the kid's got to stop growing. It doesn't appear that he stopped yet. Big, physical-looking player.
Ref calls a timeout.
And official timeout because we had a
one of the Highland guys didn't have his back pad showing. Yep, sent him off the field. It's a nice option up the middle.
And it's Miser right away, right up the middle. And he scores on the second play from scrimmage for Highland.
It's a 28-yard run, scamper right up the middle. Basically almost untouched.
Miser's a 6'2", 200-pound running back. They'll set up for the extra point. Kick is up. Kick is good. That was Carson Kwiatkowski with the kick, sophomore.
The mystery kicker's back out again. Didn't we have this same issue with, Firestone?
The kickers get no respect, Gary.
Yeah.
Kickers get no respect.
I knew this was deja vu over again.
So mystery kicker number 40 for Highland kicks it away. It's going to be shorter this time.
Much shorter.
This time McKnight comes up, handles it on the fly, and he's able to get out to the 25-yard line. So Copley takes over from their own 25. Pretty good field possession twice for Copley, Gary. Just need to put together a few first downs.
Yes, they need to just come together, get their first downs, and just build their confidence up against this Highland defense. So, I mean, most of these kids out there have played together since youth football, or against one another since youth football, and it's always been a good matchup on the line.
Highland with 13 seniors on the roster.
Airshack with the carry.
So a mature team, as we mentioned. In the middle linebacker position, you got Jack Howard, who's very familiar to our Copley group, along with Tommy Shondell. And this is a trick play.
It's going to be intercepted. Can he commit the tackle?
And it was intended for Scooby Stanford, but it's picked off by number 11, Chase Crutchley, senior captain.
Bershak's pass was intercepted by number 11, Chase Crutchley.
That's what I was going to say before this all went down. We were speaking to Jack Howard. I used to coach him back in youth football when he was at Copley.
And flag on the play. We'll see what they're going to say. It's going to be waved off. So that interception serves as a punt.
Highland will have the ball on the 49-yard line.
And Highland takes over at the 49-yard line on their end of the field. Defensively for Copley, in the middle you got Jaden Nicholas, Harper Brooks,
Vinny,
Xavier Carrillo, and Steven Lesperance.
It looks
as
like
Highland's ready to snap the ball.
Like
this time it's going to be a
starting his
end around
game.
John Silko on the carry.
We got to fill. Oh my goodness, that's just.
So Silko with a big
late
game.
Flags on the field over there on the side. We have late flags down. I have a hard time believing they didn't call the holding on Vinny Cormelli all the way down the field for 15 yards, which was kind of surprising, considering it was in a great wide open.
So another flag picked up, Gary. I didn't see what happened there.
I didn't see. I knew it was a late flag. I got through at the 20, so I'm not.
Janicus behind center again.
And it wasn't an accidental throw. I mean, he pulled it and threw it, so I'm just surprising. They waved two flags off.
Snap is back. Handoff near side. And good tackle there.
Good.
By Tony Cox. Nice tackle on number 4, Tommy Turk.
That's what you like to see your defense do. Just keep stringing it to the outside to where your help is at and just keep riding him. Which Copley has had huge problems with that off the edge. So it's kind of nice to see that happening.
Give him a little more. There you go. Perfect.
Excuse me.
This is a handoff.
And that's a touchdown.
Right up the middle, touchdown. Number 17, Evan Grant.
With the carry and the score.
So that score comes with 8:47 left in the first quarter. Highland 13, Copley 0.
Yeah, they double teamed Harper right in the middle and turned him, and they just slid straight up through there.
And Kwiatkowski's kick is good. 14-0 Highland.
Indian 0,
Hornets 14. So Copley will take their third kickoff of the game here, Gary, with just under 9 minutes remaining in the first quarter.
AAA is proud to support Copley High School Athletics. Stop by AAA for all your game day needs.
Yeah, they need to get a handle on this and slow the Hornets down, or it's going to be a very long evening.
And then this one squibbed ahead. Squibbed. Somebody's got a...
They don't... Oh, no.
Oh, my goodness.
The exact reason I just said, why is Tony so wide? I wonder why.
Looks and like that's Highland makes
miscommunication
come up
if Copley does not come up with that.
Yeah, they do.
And
come,
they do.
They
thank
do
goodness.
Come up with it.
Tony Cox comes up with it for Copley.
Says
ensures
another
the
fortunate
possession.
Event.
Copley will have the ball.
Well, Copley has been fortunate on two incidents like that. When the ball's loose, they came back up with it. We just got to get them to do something with this opportunity.
First and 10 for Copley. Gabe Manziel takes the snap, pulls it out, tries to swing it over to McKnight. Ball falls incomplete. It'll be second down and 10.
I see Copley's done some line adjustments up front from last week to this week. Trying to get a good balance of personnel up there to help protect Manziel.
Snap is back again. This one is given to Tony Cox. No room.
Hit at the line of scrimmage.
And he's going to be stacked up just behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be third down and about 11. Or no, they're going to say that's no gain on the play. Manziel takes the snap. Looking downfield, lofts one high.
Should be an interference.
Looking for, oh, geez, just off the fingertips of number 15, Jacob Kuzkowski.
Jacob
freshman.
He had good concentration on that ball, and he had trying to bring it in, but I think the reason it didn't throw the flag on interference because the cornerback had his head turned looking for the ball. So usually at that point, you just pretty much have to run somebody over to draw a flag on that.
Yeah, I thought it was good defense.
It was good.
Good concentration by
Michael
Jacob.
Lickie got a block.
Lickie's punt is not going very far. It's going to be great field position for Highland at the Copley 33-yard line.
Short punt by Lickie.
Highland will have the ball. I think Highland has figured they could get good pressure in if they just off the last one. And so they sent everybody this time, and they were able to get hands on.
Highland will have it at about 33-yard line. Janicus takes the snap. He's rolling far side. Throws it up. He's got a man.
He's got that.
And it's going to be another touchdown, Highland.
He threw that ball on the run, did not even stop to plant a foot. And threw that, 40 yards in the air, Chaz? With a wobbly pass, and he pulled that down in the corner.
Wobbly doesn't matter if it's dead on target.
Dead accurate, yeah.
And then the Copley defender needs to turn and find that
turn
ball. We got to help him out with some ball calls.
You do have
to know the ball is in the air.
When you're a defender, you have to read the receiver's eyes when you're looking at him. When he sees he's looking up for that ball, you have to bring your head around to get an eye on that. Two reasons. So you got a chance to bat it down. The other reason is it takes you out of a big interference call if you're right on that receiver.
And Kwiatkowski's extra point is good. 21 Highland, Copley 0. So we could really use a nice long Copley offensive possession right now, Gary.
Good.
A nice return, some good blocks. As we talked with the coaches earlier in our pregame interviews, It's step by step, day by day. Let's get a little bit better gradually. We're not going to change the world overnight. So each play represents an opportunity for us to get just a little bit better.
Yeah, I do watch every week. I watch them play. I do. The coaches are making adjustments as much as they can to try to make it better and better. Moving personnel around, doing some different things with the plays and on offense, stunts on defense.
And this is Bearshack with the return, but he stopped up, met at the 23-yard line by a host of Highland defenders. So he gets to about the 23-yard line.
They're down there. It's in work.
All right, here come Copley.
Copley's offense. Let's see if we can get something to move.
Hand off to Tony Cox. He
looks
swallowed.
Like he's got 2 yards, maybe.
1 yard into the line of, past the line of scrimmage. Maybe not that, even that much.
I would say, yeah, maybe. Oh, wow, they're being very favorable to that run. It's like he got 4 yards out of that one.
Copley's line really needs to get a push here. Not a lot of room for anybody to do anything. Manziel pass.
Yeah, quick pass out to the wingman.
And he completes it to Bearshack, who's hit immediately.
It looks like a loss of a yard.
No, it's going to be a pickup.
Maybe, all right, yeah. I'd say maybe a yard.
So about 3rd and 6 coming up for Copley. Manziel scrambling. He's got some room. Can he pick up the first down? And he does. Good scramble there. By Gabe Manziel.
Brought down by number 15, Chapman.
Chapman on the tackle. Ryan Zwick on the tackle. Manziel, after picking up Copley's first down, it's now to McKnight. McKnight with a nice move.
Oh, that's a hit out of bounds.
And a nice block by Bearshack.
Yeah.
But it's a gain. We'll take any gain we can get. That brings up 2nd down and about 6, maybe even 5 for Copley. A nice gain there by McKnight.
Still Copley staying with their style. The hurry-up offense, is they can keep things moving.
Manziel takes a snap, scrambles. Really just threw that one away. He knew he was in trouble.
Yeah.
So it'll be 3rd down and 5.
Which was a big gamble throw. Should have got that a little bit farther to the out of bounds, but he was put it where our receiver might have a chance at it, but
he was trying to find
there.
Scooby Stanford on the throw. Snap is back again. Hand off to Tony Cox. Tony Cox gets the corner, picks up a couple yards, and then is thrown back.
The carry brought down by number 8, Shondell.
Brings up 4th down, so.
Tommy Shondell, captain for Highland, on the tackle. Copley going for it on 4th down, might as well. Snap.
To Gabe.
Right to Gabe. Gabe tries to just push forward. He's not going to get it, though.
He's only going
to
get 3 yards of the 4, so.
So it'll be a turnover on downs. Manziel tries to pick up the 1st down with his feet. Picks up 3 of 5.
Highland ends up with the ball on what, the 43, Copley's 43-yard line. Turnover on downs.
48. Copley 48.
No, that's the 43, Chaz.
No, you're right, I'm sorry.
You had me, I called you out. I thought you were the numbers guy here. I had me confused there for a second.
I get confused often, Gary. I confuse you and I confuse me both. So Highland 3 for 3 on their first possessions, scoring wise. Janicus taking the snap. He's going to throw. Finds his receiver. It's number 5.
Oh. Scooby acted like he really didn't want too much on that. He kind of thought the guy was going to run out of bounds, so he just bumped him, and he tiptoed down the sidelines for another 4 yards after that contact.
So another first down and 10 for Highland on the pass to Sirek. Snap back. This one goes to Miser. He finds the hole, and he's going to find the end zone.
Nice moves. Cut back, and he's in there.
Looks real easy for Miser. Now he's a load, but Copley didn't even get in front of him, so we got to step up.
I saw one hand touch his jersey on the way through, but you think a back that big, somebody would be able to see him moving.
Kick is up. Kick is good. Kwiatkowski, 4 for 4. Yep. 5:34 left in the first. Copley down 4 touchdowns. So not a great start.
Nope, they have
for
no
a Copley
answers.
Team that needed to get a little traction here in the Suburban League.
How many people have watching the game tonight so far, Chaz? What are we up to?
We are up to 64 active viewers, Gary.
64. People must have knew Firestein wasn't going to be here tonight.
They're probably
so
wondering
like,
if
I'm
they,
not tuning in.
Did they tune into a track meet or a football game? They're not sure. It is a football game. Copley hopefully turns this play into a track meet and returns it 100 yards for a touchdown to get us back on the right track. And this is a squib kick up the middle.
Right up the middle. Kick it up.
Oh geez.
McKnight falls on it at what, 15-yard line? They're probably going to spot it at the 14, maybe?
McKnight falls on it at the 15, but you might have heard the coaches up here in the box. That's not what they wanted. You've got to step up and collect that ball.
Copley will be starting on the 15-yard line.
Things aren't quite as colorful from the coaches' box as they normally are tonight.
Here comes Gabe Manzel right up the middle trying to make some headway with a quarterback keeper. He's called down after no gain. Brings up second down and 10. Second snap is back. Manzel pulls it down. He's got some room. Spins. Gets up to the 24-yard line. It'll be a yard from the first down.
Yep, about a yard, half a yard short. That was all pure hustle on Gabe's part. He saw the opening in the line open up, so he just pulled it down and took off.
And this one's caught by McKnight for the first down, and he keeps the first down. Started to run backwards, thought better of it. So Copley with another first down. We're going to just take it first down by first down.
That was a good
change the world in a day, Gary. We got to get first downs. We got to start putting things together back to back.
That was a good play. Just slipped right in there beside
Manzel. Tries to get the corner, and he's whipped down after a gain of maybe one on the play. Manzel with the keeper brought down by number 34,
Zamora. Yeah, back to McKnight's catch. That was a good play call. So they saw the opening in that defense. He just slipped right into right off the back corner of Jack Howard for the pass.
And now it's a blitz by Jack Howard.
Right up the middle.
Tony Cox just smothered before he even get to the line of scrimmage.
two, three, four, five. Five.
Loss of three on the
right
play.
There, holding him up.
Three minutes and 40 seconds left in the first quarter. Snap is back. Gabe's looking downfield. Tries to find Scooby. Finds him. And Scooby was out of bounds on the catch. It'll be fourth down and 12. Copley out to punt. It'll be Licky out to punt for Copley.
I mean, with a heavy rushing line like this, the snap has to be a rifle bullet going back there. Because the faster it gets in his hands, so that he can get it off quicker.
And this is a better punt off from Licky. Gets a good bounce, and it's going to bounce up to the 42-yard line of Highland, maybe 43. They're going to say 44.
Yep.
That would have been a little more generous. Many changes yet, Gary, on the Highland offensive side of things.
I do not either.
Miser has been in and out. He's been super effective for them. Janica's still at quarterback. He's got a man in motion. He's going to give it to him. It's Mather Sirak again, and he's going to find the corner, and he's gone.
And
not even close.
Is that a 58-yard touchdown run, I believe, somewhere in that vicinity, untouched?
Oh, at least 56, because that they gave them a better mark than we thought they needed. So Highland showing their power and speed so far in the first quarter. And that kick is up and good.
The PAT is good.
34. Is that continuously run now? Is it 32 or 38? Correct. That is right. So the continuously run clock does not start to the second half. So. So our mystery kicker has got a busy night tonight.
His legs got to be tired. This is his sixth kickoff.
I'd like to give credit to somebody who could kick as good as he can, but we don't know who he is. Another squib down the middle.
13 kicks so far. This one's fielded by Scooby Stanford. Runs into his own man, then gets to the outside. Gets up to the 30-yard line. So Copley with a little better field position for this possession.
Yeah. Excuse me.
Stop by number 34, Sam Bohr.
Have to give credit out to a lot of the Copley parents that put on a great tailgating out in the parking lot before every home game. If any of you are in town and would like to tailgate with us on a home game, feel free to stop by.
And credit to Reagan Bradford for bringing me some sausages, cupcakes, fruit. Her father gets no credit. She gets all the credit, just on the record with that. Gabe Manziel brings down the fake, breaks a tackle. Able to maybe get an inch. but not much more than that. Yep. So it'll be bring up a second down and 10. Slant. He was looking for Wisniewski. Wisniewski didn't make much of a move towards it. Almost picked off by the Highland defender. Brings up third down and 10.
I believe that was Sambor. Yeah, I mean, he read that the whole way. I mean, if the pass is where it should have been, he would have picked it. The pass was low and he just couldn't pick it. He just couldn't get to it.
Gabe's forced out of the pocket. Running near side. Finds Tony Cox. Tony Cox spins, trips, falls down. It'll be fourth down and 12. Licky back to kick. Still a minute left in the first quarter. Licky puts up a good kick.
Fielded
by Syriac. He finds a hole, and he's going to find room, and he's got wheels. And it's going to be another touchdown.
Yep.
Number five, Syriac with the return and the score.
Syriac,
yeah,
big dude, 6'4", 200, and has wheels, and he's showing them off.
And some speed. A
couple times.
Some moves on him. He was definitely
Not a lot to say right now, Gary.
Not a lot.
Minute 38 left in the first quarter. Copley in a huge deficit. Not able to move the ball, not able to stop the ball. Copley looking to make some incremental improvements wherever they can.
I mean, I was even scrolling through Highland's roster here, and they only have one kicker listed. That would be number 35 doing their PATs, but number 40, or Mr. Kicker, is...
Squibb kick up the middle again. Goes to Scooby Stanford, picks it up, gets a little bit to the outside, has some room to run, makes it up to about the 34, 35 yard line.
Number 20, Wallace, kicks it out of bounds.
Thank you.
See, they did line adjustment too. They moved Bradford out to the right tackle.
Dade pulls this one down, fakes a handoff to Cox, who was in motion. Pick up a four on the play. Nice first down play from Copley.
That's
Menzel with the keeper, brought down by number 87, McKean.
Gives it to Cox again. He hits the hole hard. Picks up another couple yards. Nice run on the play. Brings up third down and
five,
about four.
Carry, brought down by number 45, Howard.
Tackled by Jack Howard on the play.
Looks like they moved.
Hansel brings it down. Searching for that first down yardage, and he gets it. First down, Copley.
I'm just, the line adjustments that they have made, it looks like it has been better for this series. And normally you don't see them making line adjustments on the fly like that, but they moved Jaden over to left guard. He put
Cox in motion. And that passes up to McKnight. McKnight breaks a tackle. Breaks another one, and it'll be a first down Copley. Big gain on the play.
Down to about the 13, or I mean the 18 rather.
About the 17 yard line.
Copley has finally crossed midfield for the first time.
So, 43 yard play for Copley. And quickly out of the gun, another pass complete to Armani Brown. So Copley finally moving the ball.
They're at the 9 yard line, looks like they're spotting it.
So it'll be first and goal from the 9. Snap is back. Gabe Manzel keeps it. He's rolling far side, looking for the corner, finds the corner, breaks a tackle, and into the end zone.
Yes.
Touchdown, Copley. Gabe Manzel.
Like I was saying, the coaches tried to make adjustments where they can, and they did a complete line adjustment this time. And I didn't see any penetration into the backfield unless, you know, it was a stunt to let the man go in. So to give a credit to the Copley coaches to making that quick adjustment just to try. So Licky's kick, it looks like it's good.
Licky's kick is good. So as we near the end of the first quarter, Highland with a big lead, but Copley finally with some positive plays on offense and putting points on the board to make it 42-7.
Yeah.
And they'll kick off for the first time.
That's really got to help the guys going into the locker room at halftime here to know that, you know, hey, we made adjustments, it worked. Let's see if we can just keep building off that in the second half.
Well, and as we've talked about, Gary, we know we got a young and experienced team. You got to build every play.
Yes.
We're not going to turn this boat around in one move. It's going to be a series of moves, building, consistently building one play after the other. Trying to get a little bit better, a little bit better, a little bit better.
And the young guys, you know, these young guys, they got to understand that their coaches are seeing things, are making adjustments for them, trying to help them against a very physical, big, and demanding team such as Highland. So no matter how well you are, there's always cracks in the armor somewhere. You just got to exploit that. You got to find it and get in there.
And this is a squib down the sideline.
Field is out of bounds.
Tommy Turk was the one trying to get his hands on it. It bounces out of bounds, so that's a good result for Copley. The ball will be on the Highland 34-yard line, which is the worst field position they've had.
That's what I was just going
since
to say.
The initial.
Since the whole game.
The whole game.
The whole game, yeah. The whole game.
4 seconds left in the first quarter. Thank you. snap is back.
The option.
And oh, and he breaks the tackle.
Two of them.
And finally,
Gabe Mansell just got a hold of the back of the jersey and brought him
and
down.
And Jamon Reeves with the tackle, but it's a big first down by Highland as the quarter comes to an end. It was Janicus on the read option keeper. As the second quarter starts, they'll take the ball over at the Copley 40-yard line heading north. And at the quarter, let's read some of our sponsors that I missed last week. So apologies again to this group. We have so many fantastic sponsors, I missed their signs. But let's start with Floors, Carpet Tile, Hardwood, Area Rugs, Wright & Montrose, all of your flooring needs. Mark Johnson, Allstate Insurance Agent. Natural Falls Construction, In-Ground Pools, Patios, etc. Community Healthcare, Snap-on Tools, EMK Tools. And we'll pause as Highland gets ready to run their first play of the second quarter. And it's a handoff. Copley strings it out pretty well and finally gets a tackle, but it's a long gain on the play. So it looks like it'll be second down and short. Childs on the tackle. Snap is back. Janicus hands it off up the middle to number 17. He breaks a tackle.
Bounces it out.
Bounces outside, and he gets a nice first down gain on the play down in deep into Copley territory.
I mean, Copley did an excellent job defensive filling that hole, but he just stepped back and bounced it to the outside.
Showed his speed. It'll be first down and goal just inside or at the 10-yard line. And here comes Janicus far side.
Wide open. I mean, it's not.
Scooby
even
falls
challenged.
Down defensively and wide open in the end zone. Completed to Syriac for his third or fourth touchdown of the day.
Yep. I mean, there was not even a person within 5 yards of him, Chaz. I mean, that was, yeah, he was.
Snap is back, kick is up.
It's good.
Kick is good. So in under 40 seconds, Highland comes out of that second quarter and puts points on the board after Copley put together their first solid drive of the offensive on the offensive side of the board. Defensively, Copley continues to struggle.
Even noticed Ricardo Childs was back in on that series, so hopefully once he gets his rhythm into the game here, hopefully the linebacker crew will be a little bit more solid.
Go in the end. So Copley now shifting up their kickoff return formation. We've got Tony Cox right in the middle of the field where they've been squibbing it. Ahead of him, you've got Javon Reeves, number six, and Caleb Wisniewski. And deep, you've got Andrew McKnight and Julian Bearshack. Another squib right up the middle. And Reeves collects it, but falls down on the 20.
Yeah.
So safe possession.
See, even a play like that, you can see where Copley has, knowing where your guys are at. I mean, he came clear across from the right side to field that in the middle of the field.
Communication, Gary.
Yeah, it's just like.
Manziel runs hard near side, but he's going to be jacked up or stacked up with a gain of maybe one on the play. Brings up second down for Copley. Gabe takes the next snap quickly out to Bearshack, who drops it. Would have been a gain of three or four on the play, but instead it will be third down.
Bearshack
low snack. Manziel does a good job getting it. Now he's being chased out of the pocket. Let's one go downfield, and it's caught. Number 15, that's the freshman, Jacob Kuskowski. Nice job going up and getting it. First down, Copley. Nice job by Manziel scrambling and finding the player downfield, keeping his eyes downfield.
Kuskowski is one of those players that continuously works hard.
He's got Bearshack near side, but he misses him. Let's one go, and another catch by Kuskowski, who tiptoes on the sideline. Gain of nine on the play. Bearshack in motion, fakes the handoff. Manziel keeps it, picks up the first down, and a couple extra yards after that.
Kuskowski is one of those players that is a great blocking receiver, but it's nice to see he can show he can still catch the ball like he has all through youth football.
Yeah, he's a nice athlete. Manziel takes the snap, gets rid of it,
standing there.
Finds his receiver.
Short of the
this
first
time
down,
it's
though.
Armani Brown with a nice catch. He had a catch in the touchdown series as well. Gain of six.
Copley is twice across midfield now.
Snap is back. Manziel keeps it. Bounces outside. Tries to break a tackle. Picks up a couple on the play. It'll be third and short.
Yes. It looked like that play was designed to go straight up the middle, but the hole closed in as soon as Gabe took his first step to shoot for it, so he had no choice but to try to bounce it out and do something.
Snap is back. It's third down and short.
And
it's going to be a pick. That one gets away from Manziel. And it's picked off by number 34, Jason Sambor. It was Armani Brown as the intended receiver.
But I think Gabe was trying to fire a bullet to the guy behind that linebacker because he went up to get that pass. I just think it was just a little bit low because he had an open man behind that linebacker.
And Janikas pulls it down again, and a nice hard run up the middle by the quarterback. Yep,
15 yards, 14 yards.
Janikas running it hard. He's not as big as his compatriots there that have been running the ball. He's got a couple of giants next to him. Janikas goes 5'9", 165, but runs with authority. And then he's got Syriac, who's 6'4", 200. And Miser, who's 6'1", 200, that have been sharing the load with him so far, among others. Handoff this time inside.
Cut back.
And a good cutback. Good speed. And finally, it's Bearshack. Or no, I'm sorry, that's Reeves takes him out of bounds. It was number 37, Rocco Leichler.
Stopped by number 6, Reeves.
But any of you that know Nate Howard, like me and Chaz do over the years, this is Nate Howard style football. Just keep running it right down your throat. If you're going to give me the shot, I'm just going to keep taking it until you stop me.
And then that's, we'll surprise theory. You with a throw over the top when you're not expecting it, which we've seen all of his patented moves today.
False start, without a doubt. Way late calling that. I mean, you're having a lot of contact down there. It did not need to happen if the refs were on that whistle.
False start on Highland.
That's Highland's first mistake tonight. But really, we've had, is that the first penalty they actually enforced tonight, Chaz? I'm thinking, I know they waved off two flags.
I think you're right, Gary.
Yeah.
Now, the ones they waved off were against Copley, but.
Yeah, which I know we wouldn't do anything wrong, which we haven't done anything wrong all night, according to the refs, which is great.
Gotta look for the silver lining.
That's right. Which does show good discipline.
Janikas pulls it down, breaks two tackles, slides down inside the 3-yard line.
Janikas with the carry and the keeper just shy of the goal.
But this has been a very clean football game. Really, no cheap shot hits, no late hits out of bounds, really to anything. And so,
first down and goal for Highland at the Copley 2.
So I will say both teams are showing great sportsmanship here.
Man in motion, Janikas hands it off to number 9. And he is stopped just short of the goal. Kyle Williams on the carry.
I mean, that right side defense had good surge on that play, and they actually knocked the Highland tackle back into him, which bumped him back, and I think that is what really stopped that play so they could get to that tackle.
Janikas snap, straight up the middle. Touchdown, Evan Grant for Highland.
Point after is good.
And the PAT is good.
Kwiatkowski. Perfect on the day, Gary. I think he's done every kickoff just as they've asked him, and he's made every extra point.
He's not the one that's doing the kickoffs. Number 35,
oh,
number
10
is our mystery kicker.
Point.
Yeah. Yeah, he is perfect on the day on his PATs, though. He is spot on. I apologize here to number 40, the kicker. I said he was number 10, so still they cannot put a handle on that ball.
Tony Cox finally picks it up and takes it across the 20 and still moving his legs. Good hard run after a little bit of a botched fielding option there. He gets it across the 25 to the 26 yard line for Copley. And again, Gary, we're going to say it again on the kickoffs. It's just communication. Somebody's got to want the ball.
Somebody's got to scream out for it. It's mine. And everybody else has just to back him up.
.642 left in the half. Be nice to see Manzo with orchestrate another long drive as he pitches it to Bearshack. Bearshack trying to get the corner but can't get there. Second down and 12.
16, Bearshack with the carry.
This time Gabe fakes the handoff. It was Bearshack coming around. He tries to take it to the short side of the field, but there's nothing there. It'll bring up third down.
Trying to get him to jump that time, it didn't work.
Third down and long for Copley. Manzel taking his time. Clock winds under 6 minutes. Manzel steps up in the pocket, nowhere to go with it, and he is sacked hard.
That was a hard
for a loss of 5 yards on the play. It'll bring up fourth down and 17.
Mm-hmm. Gabe's a little slow to get up. Now he's up. Took a hard hit up high from number 77. And he was wrapped up, and 77 just came in and just popped him.
That brings up fourth down.
Licky's nice kick is away. Nice punt, but it's going to be fielded by Syriac, and he's got room again. Stutter steps and then is tripped up. Max like Elliott was able to trip him up on the play.
It looks like Max Elliott tripped him up. I mean, he was on the move until that happened. That was. Looks like Max dove at his ankles and just took him off balance.
Good job by Max Elliott, Gary. You got to get low. That's a big ball carrier. You got to get low on the legs. You got to slow him down. He's already returned one punt for a touchdown.
Yeah.
Let's go, handoff up the middle, and a nice job there by Childs.
Yes.
Knifes into the backfield and makes a tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
He was squeezing up on that edge out here, and I thought maybe he was going to make a blitz, but he came off that. I mean, he was just like a rocket coming around that corner.
Girding was the ball carrier for Highland, number three. New quarterback in for Highland, keeps it, and he breaks a couple tackles. Finally tackled at the original line of scrimmage, gained a two on the play.
Yeah, Jaden and Sickles finally got him down over there.
Gibb is the quarterback in for Highland, number 19.
I think he's a he's a sophomore, isn't he?
I think they got a few sophomore quarterbacks that they play. This one's a handoff as the player crosses formation. It was number one, Berkmeyer, with the carry. Picks up five on the play, third down and five for Highland.
Looks like Highland's got a whole new line, almost a whole new front line in there now at this point.
Yeah, they might as well. They've got the... Might as well get reps for the younger guys. Offensive line, couple replacement quarterbacks different. Running backs are different. Receivers are different. Yeah.
It's how you build on next season, early in this season.
Snap is back. Pulls it down. He's going
to... Manny took his eye. Ball, it's a ball. That was behind the line of scrimmage pass. He threw it backwards, so that's a live ball when he dropped that.
And so with that, it's a turnover on downs, and Copley will get the ball back. Their first defensive stop of the game. They'll get the ball back on their own 34-yard line. 2:58 left in the half.
See if we can put a couple quick plays together here and eat this clock out to the half.
Snap is back to Manziel. His ball is short. Skipped it. It was well covered by the Highland defense.
That ball hit the dirt four yards short of the receiver. I think he was trying to put so much on that he just was late releasing it and drove it right
into the ground.
You may
have also seen the coverage, Gary. Everyone was covered. You're throwing into...
Yeah.
Tight coverage that doesn't make a quarterback feel good. This time he finds Stanford, but Stanford can't hold on to it. It would have been a first down if he could have.
I mean, you have to make those plays. I mean, that was a very catchable ball. But you have to get your hands on those, and you got to make the catch, then worry about the run afterwards.
Just get the first down. Manziel again.
Nice lofting pass to Scooby
again.
That'll be a flag. They're going to drop it.
Well defended by number 88.
Oh, calling a flag on the interference on that.
Colton Faust was on the defense.
Wow.
.240 left in the half now. Copley forced to make a decision. I think with that much time left in the half, you got to punt it away. Two chances at a first down.
Looks like that's what they're doing.
Odds are not with you.
Looks like they might be coming after this. So, yep, they didn't get it though.
Good punt. Back to receive.
It's a slight bobble, but.
And we got.
Still on his feet, finally down with the 40.
Luke Berkmeyer was the returner for Highland. He brings it back about 25 yards to the Copley 40-yard line.
Now you can hear the Copley coaches starting to liven up over there a little bit.
Highland will have 2:24 left on the clock here in the half to add to their lead. Copley's got an opportunity to stop, get a good stop, and some positive momentum going into the half.
Highland takes it off from Copley's 40, so.
Jules, turn your head in! Jules, turn your head in! Jules!
And quarterback pulls it down. Keeper is able to lunge ahead for a gain of 3 on the play. Still number 19, Gibb at quarterback. Snap is back. Handoff up the middle again. He's tripped up after a gain of a couple. We'll bring up 3rd down and 6. 1:30 remaining in the half. Snap is back, handoff coming near side. Cut by number 3, bounces outside, and finally brought down from behind by Armani Brown, who's actually been working really hard today. He's made a couple game-saving tackles from behind as their running backs have slipped and weaved and navigated through our defense. That'll bring up 1st down and 10 at the Copley 13-yard line. And this is another handoff up the middle. Number 3 slips another a tackle, slips another tackle, and he's into the end zone.
Makes an embarrassing jump across the line. He's getting called for unsportsmanlike
conduct. Lucas Gurney with a touchdown.
Yeah, for that jumping leap that he did. So there's a flag down. It'll be unsportsmanlike, but they'll still get the score. Cases like that, your ends are supposed to stay home and wait for those cutbacks. But when there's nobody out there at home, I mean, that's a free run. Now you're depending on your cornerback or your safety to try to get up to make that tackle. And normally they're tied up on a block back there. So, I mean, that's a sure 5 yards easily on a cutback like that if your defensive end is not staying home.
So with 37 seconds left in the half, Highland 63, Copley 7. Copley goes out to receive another kickoff. The second half will open with Highland receiving the ball. In case they didn't have enough opportunities this half.
Yes, just in case. So the question is, will Highland stay with the squib kicks, or will they kick this one deep since they're taking that unsportsmanlike penalty or stepping it back off the kickoff here?
If I'm them, I'm not worried about it. There's 37 seconds left in the half.
But if you can do a squib kick here and possibly recover it, get another touch, you know,
I think they just kick it off and trust that their defense will hold.
At some point, they got to call, you know, Highland. Of course, you know, it looks like they put a lot of the JV or, you know, second string players in. I shouldn't say JV. They got enough players that would just be their second string players of their varsity.
Forzio is the kicker, we just learned. Thank you, Grant.
He's squibbing it.
Squib up the middle.
Still haven't fielded it.
And Copley finally falls on it at the 1 yard or at the 30-yard line.
Three Copley players touched that. The third one finally got his hands on it and fell down on it on the 30.
Copley will have the ball with 34 seconds left in the half.
Manzel in the backfield with Bearshack. Takes a snap, hands it off up the middle. Bearshack breaks the tackle, gets to the outside. First down, Copley. Clock is running, 30 seconds. Clock will stop to reset the chains.
The clock is back running again now.
Snap is back. Bearshack with it again. Bounces outside. Got some room. Can he find the end zone? Chipped up almost. He gets to the end zone. Touchdown, Copley.
8 seconds left.
So Bearshack with 8 seconds on the clock remaining in the half.
He did well keeping his balance on that shoestring tackle coming in.
He did. I thought they had him on the sideline, Gary, but he's able to.
Yeah, he did very well keeping it on that edge and tiptoeing. And you get.
Oh, flag on the field. They're going to pick it up. I didn't see what the call was.
It was. Copley declined it, so. Let's see if Michael Licky can get it through the uprights here. And I believe he does.
And Licky's 218 is good. Copley, 14, Hornets, 63.
There's another flag down on the play. Unsportsmanlike on Copley now, celebrating. That looked like it might have been Bradford and Licky getting way too excited about a PAT, but.
PAT with this deficit is nothing to celebrate, right?
100%. The kick was with authority. I mean, he had it well above the uprights and way deep, but beautiful kick, but you just, you know, you high-five and walk back to the huddle and say nice, or to the sidelines, just say nice kick and go on.
I think the Highland coach, in a show of sportsmanship, is trying to decline it. Don't know if he's even permitted to do that.
Yeah, I don't. Don't know how you can get the refs just to call it off, but. Unless for some reason I'm completely wrong on who the call was on, but with the celebration I saw in the middle of the field there, or at the center of the field at the line of scrimmage, I'd have put money on it. It was on Copley. And I'm right.
They are going to walk it off. So just what Copley needs to give Highland another chance to score with 8 seconds on the clock in the half. How fancy would an onside kick be here, Gary? Highland is holding back.
Yeah, Highland's not respecting. They think they're just going to kick it down through. A little bit of confusion on Copley's lineup there. That was the onside kick, you called it, and they let it, Highland let it go out of bounds. They walked about the 40.
That'll be another penalty. Unless they said somebody touched it.
But look, the one Highland player did touch it.
Oh, well, that's good. So Highland with the ball at the Highland 42-yard line.
It looks like that's where they're going to give a spot at. So does Highland take a couple shots here in this 8 seconds, or just do true sportsmanship and take a knee and just get into the locker room? And
looks like they're going to take a knee. They've got Janica's back in at quarterback.
Yeah, and they got everybody crowded around, tight on him. So,
so with that,
off to the locker room.
Highland Meals, and that will conclude our first half.
A rough first half for your Copley Indians. A dominant first half for the Highland Hornets. Second half will be coming at you in about 20 minutes.
Yep.
In the meantime, we're going to leave our camera on with a microphone live so that you can listen to the bands. Enjoy the halftime show. We'll be back in 20 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, we proudly present the 2023 Pride of Highland Marching Band. We open tonight's performance with a Dave Matthews Band modern rock single off of their 1995 debut studio album. Here is Ants Marching. Our next song is a country music track, originally recorded in the early 90s, but made most famous in 2004 by the Rascal Flatts. This is Bless the Broken Road. Tonight's performance with a 1979 classic rock track from Styx that tells the story of an outlaw who was captured for bounty. Here is Renegade.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the field the pride of Copley High School, your Copley High School Marching Band. The band is under the direction of Michael Foster, Christina Wade, and Aaron Welker. The band is led on the field by drum majors Aya Abbas and Chad Snelling. Tonight, the Copley Band would like to share two of the four parts of their 2023 competition show entitled Your Life's Blueprint, featuring Rhapsody in Blue by George Gershwin and original music by Jeff Chambers. Our soloist this evening is Henry Foster on tuba.
Henry. Second one with the back turn.
Falls your lot to be a street sweeper, sweep streets like Michelangelo painted pictures, sweep streets like Beethoven composed music, sweep streets like Shakespeare wrote poetry. Sweep streets so well that all the host of heaven and earth will have to pause and say, here live the great street sweeper who swept his job there. Thank you.
please welcome to the field our very own Copley Fairlawn 8th grade band. The 8th graders have been working hard to prepare a very special performance for you this evening. They'll be doing Neil Diamond's classic hit, Sweet Caroline.
$476. The winning ticket is a pink ticket
6, 5, 6. Again, a pink ticket. 9, 4, 2, 6, 6, 5, 6. If you're the lucky winner, please make your way to the media booth and collect your winnings.
Oh, good luck.
Ladies and gentlemen, this game will now be played with a running clock per the OSHA point differential rule. The clock will only be stopped after changes of possession at the end of period, when a score occurs, and for official or team timeouts. If the point differential should fall below 30 points, normal clock operations will resume. Thank you. Fans, I want to remind you of tomorrow's event, the first annual Copley Fire and Rescue Association Food Truck Festival. It'll be tomorrow from 2 to 8 o'clock at Copley Community Park. It's going to feature 11 food trucks, one celebrity chef. For the kids, there'll be superheroes and princesses, face painting, a balloon artist, foam zone for the kids. And then for the adults, there'll be 2 craft beer vendors as well as 2 local wine vendors. Please help support, and we hope to see you tomorrow.
So you might have just heard Copley Fire and Safety is sponsoring a food truck bonanza tomorrow at Copley Community Park. Food trucks, games, celebrity chefs, etc. In the meantime, let's get through the rest of our sponsors. Thank you in advance. A few more that we didn't get to last week: Copley Tool Rentals, KW Servic Realty, Lake Monroe Design, BMW and VW of Akron, and then, of course, Copley Police and Copley Fire. And then I'm going to start at the top again with the ones I missed last week. Floors, Mark Johnson from Allstate, Natural Falls Construction, Community Health Center, Snap-on Tools, EMK Tools, NFC Tree Express, lot clearing, trimming, pruning, etc. Copley Tool Rental, KW Servic Realty, Lake Monroe Design, BMW, VW of Akron, Copley Police, Copley Fire. And then at the very top of the list, going back to the ones we hit on last week, Megan McDonald, State Farm, Metropolitan Veterinary Hospital, Ozzy Antiques, PBS, Chemistry for Life, Absolute Fitness. Chris Ayoub has got so many clients over there you can barely park, so get in there and get your workout on. Akron Pest Control, Lewis Landscaping, Copley Fairlawn Veterinary Clinic, Witchy Witchy Firestein, Committed Candid Innovative Council, The Eyesight, Summers Insurance Group, Rizzi's Ristorante and Pizzeria, Copley Teachers Association, Medina Auto Mall, Buick and GMC, Chick-fil-A of Montrose, Cardinal Cakes and Coffee, Swenson's, Miller Middendorf, Century 21 Agents, Loyal Oak Golf Club, Firehouse Tavern, CompuCharts, Valley Dental, Floors, Mark Johnson, and I'm already back to the beginning. So I'll pause there as we get ready to start the second half of play. Julian Bearshack out for the halftime discussion with the referees. I believe it'll be Highland receiving here to start the third quarter.
I believe so. I'd like to go back with the sponsors. I'm not sure if Old Carolina Barbecue was on your list, but they provided team dinner for the football team.
Good
afternoon.
One, Gary. Thank you. That's perfect. I did miss them. Appreciate you bringing that up.
They sent enough food to feed two football teams, which was excellent. And the boys definitely took advantage of it from what I hear. So. I'm sure most of you heard this second half. It starts off with a running clock.
And it's Matthew Licky out to kick off for Copley. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It was funny, Chaz, your wife was asking me if we were running out of things to talk about up here.
I didn't see how that's
possible.
Getting
close. We'll just keep repeating our sponsors. We'll make we'll get the most bang for our buck.
And the kickoff, Michael Lickley squibs it off. Picked up, one tackle miss, two tackles miss, three tackles
and
got it.
Finally, Tony Cox is able to trip up the ball carrier, but not before he gets it back to the Copley.
Across the 50, the
48-yard line.
Yep, I'm going to say it looks like it's where they're spotting it.
So Copley's got a lot of pressure on him here to make a stop. Mm-hmm.
I believe that's the shortest return they've had so far. I mean, where he fielded that, he's only, it was what, 12, 13 yards he ran back, so.
Snap is back, handoff is made.
The 47.
Running back able to bounce ahead for a gain of 3 or 4 on the carry.
Is that Dylan Lazar, it looks like? 47 they handed it to, if I'm correct on that.
Good point. Grant Hine in the booth with us running the camera. If you have any students out there that are tuned in or parents of students, we are on full recruiting mode for any audio, visual, and or broadcasting interest. We'll teach you how to do any of the above, and it includes football, basketball, soccer, lacrosse, and there might be more that I'm missing, but let's start with those. If you have interest in broadcasting, running a camera, setting up, tearing down, any of those options, please get in touch with Athletic Director Andy Jawan, and he'll point you in the right direction. And with that, it brings up 3rd down and 3. Copley looking to hold. Optimal scenario would be for Copley to have a full media committee slash club that would run this entire broadcast. And a nice job by Childs from the backside. Chases down the ball carrier, drops him for a loss. It'll be 4th down and 4. It was Berlin on the run.
He has definitely picked, he has gained a lot of speed over the years. Lost a lot of weight, put a lot of muscle on, and gained a lot of speed. And boy, he just came from the backside untouched and ran it down completely on the other side in the backfield. Oh. It's going to be encroachment on Copley, or? Yep, it's encroachment on Copley. But those are the middle mistakes you cannot make when you're right on top of the ball. I mean.
So that'll be 1st down. Highland, a free one.
Yep, that was a free one.
Snap is back. Quarterback pulls it down, keeps it. And that's the other Child's brother coming up and laying the lumber. Ricardo Childs on that tackle. Short gain on the play.
Kind of tackling you like to see, straight up hard hitting, grab and take the man down.
Man in motion, hands it off across formation. He's got some room, gets to the corner and is able to turn it up, breaks a tackle, and he's into the end zone.
Number 1, Brookmeyer with the run and the score.
Brookmeyer, touchdown.
See, Copley's put some new faces in the backfield. And the PAT.
Kick is good.
And the PAT is good. Indians 14. Hornets 70. Copley fans, if I could please direct your attention to the track as we take this opportunity to introduce our varsity cheerleaders performing.
Here come your cheerleaders from Copley.
Starting with the seniors, Cam Brantley, Caitlin Byerly, Mac Goswodinski, Lily Gottlieb, Liam Kuskowski, Claire Oshman, Lexi Stone, juniors Tanner Burton, Lily Barwell, Mia Klepps, Addison Miller, Brielle Neuhauser, Reese Knoll, Taylor Williams, and sophomore Maddie Haddad.
Thank you, Copley cheerleaders. Great job.
I believe the theme
and I think Grant did a nice job capturing those cheerleaders as that squib kick goes straight
nice
to Tony Cox. Catches it out of the air, waits for some blockers. Nothing so there. Bounces it back near side, looking to go up the field, but it's a swarm of Hornets that take him down at about the 32-yard line.
Number 5, Tony Cox with the carry.
I mean, that was good hands by him. He just picked that right out of the air, tucked it in, and waited for the blocking to set up before he made his move. What I was getting ready to say, the suit and bodies theme tonight was the red, white, and blue, which we haven't seen much over there. They've been extremely quiet.
Change at quarterback here for Copley. Madden, number 12, in at quarterback.
Kind of thought that might be happening. I've seen him warming up here on the sideline right after the half.
Hand off up the middle to Childs. Picks up a couple on the play.
32, Ricardo Childs with a carry brought down by number 76, Thomas Fern.
Another one to Childs up the middle. Picks up another 3 or 4 on the play. Brings up 3rd down and 6. Maybe 5, we'll give it 5.
I think I can say about Anderson over the years watching him play, there's very few people out there that have what I would call football knowledge to feel where of the field, who's supposed to be where at what time, and when.
And off the Childs again, as Gary's given the bio on Madden, he gets real close to the first down. He's going to be within a yard.
Ricardo Childs again with the carry.
We just got to figure out a way to get these Madden boys to grow big. they would be unstoppable.
Well, I've got enough muscle milk at my house, Gary, to...
You think it should be happening then, right?
Oh, handoff up the middle, but Copley's not going to get it.
Mm-mm. No, he's definitely short.
And that'll be a turnover on downs. Highland with a nice defensive stand. It was runs up the middle. 4 in a row for Copley, and they just can't get that 10-yard mark.
I think that would have been a good time for a keeper, for the quarterback keeper on the outer edge, because he's been running a good fake out there, and nobody's even acknowledging he's taken that fake out there. Yes, we did.
Copley turns it over on downs. Highland will have the ball, the 42-yard line.
So I see they got Kuskowski in playing corner on the left side now. which is a new change in for defense.
And new quarterback for Highland is Eli Howard. He gives it up the middle, and this
47
is going to get tripped up by his own feet. Yes. It was number 47, Dylan Lazar, with a nice gain down to the Copley 5-yard line.
47 Lazar with the carry.
So at one point in youth football, the Highland quarterback that's currently on the field and Copley's last quarterback were the two quarterbacks for Copley youth football, Gary.
That is exactly true.
So Eli Howard readies to take the snap for Highland. One of the better face-off guys in lacrosse.
Yes, and if you don't know,
in the area,
his older brother Jack Howard is the starting middle linebacker.
Team Howard with the carry, stop by 33, Ronakai Child.
It'll be second and goal from the 4. Hand off up the middle again, number 47. Lazar weaves his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Highland.
To give you an idea on Lazar.
Hey,
he's a 5'4", 150 pounds. He's not a big man, but man, he is a lot of fight in him.
He runs hard, he hits the hole hard.
Very fast.
Now Eli Howard in to hold for the kick. Snap is back, snap is down, snap is
good.
Or kick is good, excuse me.
They're saying no good.
No good.
I thought it was low, but I thought it went across the bar, but apparently it must have been.
I did too. Well, we're both old and with a bad angle and bars in the booth, Gary, so who are we to try and judge from here?
Not that Highland needed one more point, but.
The perfect game day play, some Chick-fil-A. Order your favorites ahead through the Chick-fil-A app and earn rewards.
So it looks like there's no changes on the kick receiving team. Cox is still covering the middle for the skib quick, or the squib kick. Try to say that 5 times fast.
And this is a
right
deep
to Cox.
Kick.
He calls it up. Oh, man.
Picks it up. Makes a cut. Not a lot of room to go. Now he's got a lead blocker. McKnight with a block. Able to pick up a few extra yards on that near side corner off the McKnight block.
Got it out to the 29.
So here comes the Copley offense. They'll look to put together a little bit better of a series here with a first down or two and hopefully a score. Madden back at quarterback. Ricardo Childs at running back. McKnight, Scooby.
They did a huge changeup on the offensive line here. Looks like got a lot of JV underclassmen playing.
Childs with a nice run on the handoff, picks up 3 or 4 yards on the play.
Ricardo Childs with the carry, brought down by number 76.
Following his blockers.
Looks like they got Max Elliott in the center. Vinny Carmelli looks like it's a guard. Looks like they got Nico Inberg out at tackle. Madden running for his life.
Number 12, Madden with the keeper.
He's very elusive, Chaz. Looks like they've got him, and it's just a little slide move, and he's just, I think it's a lot of lacrosse player in him.
He's elusive. We need to work on his power, Gary. I like the elusiveness, yep, for sure. But anyway, we're back to the original line of scrimmage, so third down and 10, passing down. See if Madden can get a completion here. Snap is back, low snap, pulls it down, scrambles, eyes downfield. And he just gets rid of it out of bounds. Nobody open down the field.
It's very good thinking on his part, which is one thing he normally doesn't do. He'll fight to the end before he'll throw it away, but he was quick judgment to get rid of it and punt it out.
So Licky will punt with 34 seconds remaining in the third quarter. His punt is up. It's going to be received and immediately tackled by Max Elliott. So Highland takes over at their own 41-yard line.
Max Elliott was the long snapper on that. That's how it's supposed to be done. Snap, downfield, cover the kick. He should be the first man down the field. Smart heads up play by Max.
.20 seconds left in the third quarter with the running clock. Copley's defense back on the field. I don't think Highland's going to get a playoff here, nor do they really care.
No, I don't think you're pushing that envelope at all. Just looks like the quarterback, Eli, is a little bit upset on that because he was kind of holding his hands up like, why, walking to the sidelines.
Well, there's one thing I know about Eli Howard, he's a competitor.
100%.
So he wanted one more extra chance.
Yes, and I'm not sure whose call was that, whether that was
his dad's call,
because, you know, he's the offensive coordinator over there.
Handoff up the middle again, breaks the tackle.
Oh, breaks another tackle.
Pass breaks another tackle. And just like that, Highland scores again.
Scores like that. And one of the closest men to catch it to him was the right corner, ran clear across the field to try to catch him and almost had him about the 5-yard line, which was Jacob Kuskowski. He's got a lot of speed, but he just could not get there. You know, the flag was on Highland. Do you know what it was, Chaz?
Why? So they'll march back this kick, and the elusive number 40 will be taking this extra point.
Yep. Our mystery kicker is back. He's going to see what he can do. And I think we know why he stays with kickoffs, Chaz. That's two of them he's missed.
All right, Copley will get the ball back again. Lots of opportunities on offense, not able to do much with it.
Mm-hmm.
used vehicle, look no further than Medina Auto Mall. They offer a diverse selection of Buick and GMC sedans, trucks, and SUVs that can fit any lifestyle or budget. Medina Auto Mall and Northeast Ohio Buick GMC dealers are proud sponsors of the Copley, Ohio School Indian.
I mean, if you wanted a game to work on your special teams to perfect them, this would be a perfect one.
That's
make
a great
your adjustments,
point, Gary.
Make your
way to
make,
find our next
make
topic.
Your personnel changes and get something to find something that works. I see they got a few new ones in up front up here.
Squib kick up the middle. Tony Cock. Oh, my goodness. And then Bearshack falls on it on the 15.
He grabs the handle on it, but actually, I don't know whether it looks like he was slipped or tripped over his own feet or just grabbed it and fell down. I'm not exactly, I couldn't make any, it made no sense to me what he was doing there. Because the ball kind of went through Cox's hands right to him. And
Madden back out at quarterback. You've got Wisniewski as a wideout.
Looks like you got Max Elliott back in.
Kuskowski is a wideout. Armani Brown is a wideout. Snap is back. Hand off to Childs. He's ripped down. Loss of 2 yards on the play.
32, Ricardo Childs with the carry.
I mean, our tackle out there on that play just couldn't seal that edge for Childs to get out there to make to cut that corner.
There we go. A little room on the outside for Copley.
Oh.
And then a hard tackle, but it's Armani tackle. Brown that picks up 9 or 10 yards on the play.
Yeah.
Brings up third down and about 3. Third down and 1, excuse me. No gain on the play. We'll bring up fourth down and 1.
I mean, this second string for Highland, I mean, they're amped up to play. I mean, you got a squad this big, any opportunity you get to show that you can play, you got to do it. And these guys are playing with a lot of energy out there for Highland right now.
Stop by number 13, Howard.
Somebody missing themselves on the line out there on a kick.
Oh,
it kicks
goodness.
Over, snaps
pick it up,
over
pick
his
it
head.
Up. Oh.
And that's and they're marking it down into 1. He saved a touchback. I apologize. That would have been a safety if he was still in the end zone.
I'd rather have taken the safety, to be honest this, with you.
Highland gets the ball on the half yard line right now. I mean, I'm just going to guess this play. I'm going to guess an Eli Howard's just going to fall forward. Could be wrong on that, Chaz, but I just have that. Eli's up under center.
He's going to take a knee. Some good sportsmanship here by Highland. After an unfortunate series by Copley.
My guess is they might take another knee and then maybe try a field goal for practice, Gary. Let's see what they do.
That would be a good idea just for practice, but I got a feeling at this point, I think they've Highland coaching staff has made their statement, and I got a feeling that they're letting the clock run as down as, I mean, it's a continuous running clock, so. They're just letting time, you know, the play clock run down as far as they can before they turn the ball back over. I don't think they're gonna kick it. I think they're gonna take another knee and turn it back over. To see, they got another long snapper warming up down here on the sidelines.
And another punter.
And another punter.
Highland is continuing to take a knee.
So they'll turn it over on downs. A nice show of sportsmanship. At this point, Highland probably wants Copley to put together a long drive. They'll get their guys some reps. Copley gets their guys some reps.
Yep. This is going to get a feel for tomorrow's JV game.
Highland turned it over on downs. Copley will have the ball at the 5-yard line.
So I guess on the other side of them turning it over, I mean, us that know Nate Howard would get humor out of this. So
nowhere for Childs to go with it on that carry.
Because, you know, taking a knee when you could have punched on in, I guess, you could always, you know, there's been known that Nate Howard doesn't have much of a heart when it comes to football. It's just shoved right down your throat, but I guess there is a soft spot in Nate, Chaz.
I've seen it many times. He's a real teddy bear.
Bad snap. Ooh, Howard was running.
Low snap. Madden's able to get it out to the 2.
Very smart by keeping his knee off the ground and getting the ball picked back up and getting out of the end zone.
Copley's definitely trying to give Highland some more points here at the end of the game. Highland's doing their best not to take them. I would like to get a first down. Run a positive play here, Gary.
13 yards to get the first down on third down, so. I'm not exactly sure why at that point they didn't let Madden show his arm that he's got and chose to run that play, but. So Copley's going for it? Is that what I'm seeing here? They're going to do a pooch kick probably, I would hope, maybe. I'm not sure. Another bad snap. And it's in the end zone.
Jesus.
It's a touchdown for the Hornets.
Well, Highland showed their sportsmanship, and Copley turned it down.
Didn't know that was violence.
What's up?
Didn't know that was violence.
That was a Highland touchdown by number 70.
Did you see who was in the quarterback on that chance?
It was Anderson.
Was that Anderson?
But it was another low snap.
I know it was right on the ground. There was, two people trying to get it picked up, which creates chaos. They give them 2 points on that?
To be honest, I was looking at my notes here.
86, and they only went to 88, but that should have been a touchdown unless they're calling it was down in the end zone before they recovered it. Needed any more of the points. But
the game is over. I hate to belabor it any longer than we have to, Gary. So thanks for tuning in.
Yep, thanks. Everybody being here.
Congratulations to both teams and coaches for a well-played contest.
I believe next week we're away at Aurora, but it's on a Thursday, so no live stream for that. Thanks for tuning in, and enjoy your weekend.
Yep.